You're watching Cartel TV and I'm Simone.
Now, Jenny's already done a pretty thorough review of the new D-MAX LSU crew cab.
So I rocked up to the Cartel TV office today and I found this beast waiting for me. Yes, it's a D-MAX and it's its top trim, the X-Terrain. So I thought, I'm not gonna do any office work today. Instead, I'm gonna take this baby down for a short day trip to the beach for some off-roading. And while we're on the journey, I'm gonna explain some of the main features. So join me and let's have some fun.
Being the top trim, we'll focus more on what it's like to drive and live with in a way that most people will use the X-Terrain.
While all utes are conceived as workhorses, the top trims of many of them are now far more luxurious and they're obviously aimed at more than just hauling working equipment.
Many of these will be used by families with an adventurous spirit, those who spend their time between shuttling kids to school and having fun outdoors over the weekend.
This is what I'm gonna do. Well, not the kids and school part, but I'm gonna drive out of the city. I'm gonna head down the expressway out of the city in search of some nice off-road conditions to challenge the D-MAX on, including a beach run to see just how close to the water I'm willing to get this top version.
I'll try to pay more attention to things like on-road comfort, noise levels, and also the tech that keeps us safe and entertained during the trip.
Now, it was a little bit noisy at the office, so before I set off on my trip, I've brought the X-Terrain to a nearby park so I can tell you a little bit about the design.
The X-Terrain comes in only one version, a crew cab 4x4 with an automatic gearbox. And it has some special design perks on the inside and out, as well as some cool tech.
There are a few different ways to distinguish the X-Terrain from the other models, but if you're still not sure, X marks the spot.
It also has this blacked out grille that looks just awesome, and plastic cladding.
Now, when you add plastic cladding to an SUV, it actually makes it look more rugged, but when you add it to a ute, it actually makes it look more luxurious.
The 18-inch wheels are also special on the X-Terrain with a special darkened finish.
What's that? Oh, the beach is calling. So let's set out and I'll tell you what it's like to drive.
So let's get in and enjoy this pre-cooled cabin. The X-Terrain has a remote engine start function and you can also start the aircon before you get into the car on a hot day or preheat the vehicle on a cold winter morning.
So we're in the city now and I have to say it doesn't feel at home as such in tight city streets and parking spots.
It's a big ute and definitely aimed at wide streets, open roads and nature.
Basically the only downside in the city is its size, but you really wouldn't want it to be any smaller because it's got everything else on its side.
The ute body, although large, makes it really easy to predict where all the angles are, and loads of safety tech helps a lot.
And I mean loads. The new D-MAX has a 5-star ANCAP safety rating, tested this year, and packs the latest tech.
First of all, your phone functions will be presented on this 9-inch touchscreen via Apple CarPlay or Android Auto. And voice recognition also helps with controls when you need to keep your eyes on the road. Parking and navigating tight spaces is made very easy via this camera, rear and front park assist, and also rear cross traffic alert.
Now that feature is just awesome when you're backing out from a driveway into the street.
People who are a bit anxious about driving such big vehicles in the city will welcome Miss Acceleration Mitigation. This system is employed when you're driving slowly and it determines if you actually applied the accelerator by accident.
If it detects a collision, it'll apply the brakes in spite of your accidental throttle push.
You also get heaps of other safety features such as blind spot monitoring, forward collision warning, AEB and more. But let's get out on the open road.
This new generation of utes definitely has some models which are much better on the open road.
Things like adaptive cruise control and lane guidance assist make it a breeze to drive on the open road. Adaptive cruise control also has stop and go functionality. The wipers and self-leveling headlights turn on and off automatically, and both front and rear screens have UV protection glass to reduce the effects of UV rays and heat buildup.
So I've been out on the expressway for a little while now, and I'm starting to notice a little bit of road noise, but my seat's comfortable, and it's actually really easy to find a good sitting position.
Tilt and telescoping steering wheel and electric seat adjustments help you adjust the position to your liking.
The whole team at Cartel TV tried out the X-Terrain and I have to say that none of us had any issues with finding the perfect sitting position.
We haven't got much weight in the back and we aren't towing anything, so it is a bit jumpy over harder bumps at higher speeds.
However, reading that it has a three-leaf setup made me think it'd be a lot worse, but it's not. Sure, it's not a cushioned air suspension, but it's really not as harsh as you'd expect a non-loaded ute with a three-leaf setup to be.
Here I should point out that single cab models have a more hardcore rear setup that's definitely harsher when unloaded. So bear in mind that this is a crew cab model here.
Body roll is also present, expectedly, but I have to say that it's been significantly reduced.
But all this is in testing conditions. You know, we throw it around a bend to see body roll.
If you're driving as you usually would on a smooth surface of the open road at legal speeds, then the X-Terrain is a comfortable and accommodating cruiser.
Speaking of which, getting up to those speeds is not lightning fast, but it is effortless. cars. The engine with 140 kilowatts of power and 450 newton-meters of torque is no powerhouse, but it works like a charm with this automatic gearbox. While driving through the city, I really loved the low-down push, as all the torques come from just 1600 revs. Things get even better when you know that at 1400 revs, you have 400 newton-meters, and 300 newton-meters is available from 1000 revs. That's more than you'll need in most everyday situations, and you get it just above the idle engine speed.
This is so noticeable when you're driving. Getting up to speeds is super easy, and it's only noisy when you push the pedal to the metal.
In most conditions, the gearbox will shift before 2500 revs, and I just love that. You keep the noise levels down and still feel the confident push. While cruising the expressway, I got to enjoy some of the awesome new safety features like the adaptive cruise control, which was quick and easy to get used to. Also, when combined with the lane keep assist, it helped make effortless work of my journey to the beach. Oh, but before we got there, I just had to stop for a quick bite at a coastal cafe. Yum, yum.
So we're finally here at beautiful Goolwa Beach. Now let me tell you a bit about the off-road numbers before we take her for a ride on the sand.
Understandably, 4x4 models have 2 high, 4 high and 4 low. And they also now have a rear differential lock in 4 low. Ground clearance for the X-Terrain is at 240 millimeters and wading depth is now 800 millimeters. Approach angle is 30.5 degrees, departure angle 24.2 degrees and ramp over angle 23.8 degrees. These numbers are for the X-Terrain. They are not the same for all body styles. By the way, if you're towing, you'll love the 3.5 ton brake towing capacity on models with the optional tow bar kit, as well as trailer sway control. All 4x4 models get steel underbody guards. Not something we'll really need on the beach, but if we went rock crawling, this would be a must. Some other features include hill start assist that prevents rollback when starting off on steep gradients, and hill descent control for those scary downhill sections off-road. The three-leaf rear setup is amazing for wheel articulation, and ladder chassis is now even stronger and wider with an added crossmember for even more rigidity. But you know, just taking the D-MAX to my local beach is almost like getting the late Stephen Hawking to sit a year 10 math test. I could tell the D-MAX wanted and was capable of much more. In saying that, there's nothing like the freedom of driving a capable off-roader along a deserted beach.
After this beautiful day out in the D-MAX X-Terrain, I have to say that this family version of the workhorse is a really good choice for an active family.
It keeps the hauling ability that utes are famous for, but it's also impressive off-road, nice to drive, and as at home in the city as something of its size can be.
We're seeing more and more of these luxurious utes out on the road, and while some people are eager to dismiss them as status symbols or even gimmicks, I feel that they're actually very capable, versatile, and welcome options on the market. Thanks for watching Cartel TV. Now, if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel and follow us on the socials. Now, if you had the D-MAX X-Terrain, where would be your ideal place to take it four-wheel driving? I'd love to know, and my favorite answer will win an Isuzu D-MAX cap. We'll see you soon.